Basic structure doctrine has minor flaws but benefits overweigh the fallacies to a larger extent, making it as an integral part of the constitutional interpretation. Basic structure doctrine. Why it was introduced by the judiciary? It was introduced by the judiciary in the context of amendability of the constitution or the amending powers of the constitution. Amendment is inevitable because no constitution, howsoever finally written, can remain static for all times. Constitution is a living document, it has to reflect to the changing time and the need of the people. So amendment is inevitable, howsoever finally it was written. But while giving power of amendment to the parliament under 368, it should not be misconstrued that constitution approves plenary power of the parliament to amend the constitution or unrestricted power of the parliament to amend the constitution. Even though in the Shankari Prasad case, the court held that it has a constitutional legislative power which has the creative power of the constitution. But in the subsequent case, Golaknath case, it says that there is no CLP. Amendability cannot be done by parliament. It has to be done only by a separately created constituent assembly. When 24th Amendment Act amended 368 and Article 13 and denied the power of judicial review, then Supreme Court came out with the basic structure doctrine, the case of the Bharati case, 1973, telling that there are some essential ingredients of the constitution which cannot be changed, which cannot be violated. Constitution can be equated with religion. It has two parts, one changeable part, another is non-changeable part. The basic belief in the religion cannot be changed, so as basic structure cannot be violated. But the ritual keeps changing based on the demands of the time. The core values don't change, rituals may change. Likewise, there are two parts in the constitution, one which forms the essential foundation of the constitution which cannot be violated, and the other can change. It is a judicial creativity, it is a judicial innovation, because it was judiciary which was able to ensure that constitution is not empowering the parliament to become totalitarian. If parliament is having unlimited power, then according to the political expediency, those having majority in the parliament can amend the constitution according to their whims and fancies, thereby converting the democratic government into a totalitarian state. And this was checked appropriately by judicial innovation called as basic structure. So basic structure is providing dynamism to the constitution. It ensures the constitutional supremacy. It presents, it helps in the growth of the constitution, that is the evolution of constitutionalism. And basic structure helps in the protection of the fundamental rights of the individuals. So basic structure doctrine helps in the growth of vibrant democracy in India today. Through a number of pronouncements, the court has told rule of law, secularism, republican form of government, parliamentary form of government, even preamble becomes the basic structure of the constitution. Thereby, basic structure constitution has resulted in becoming the axiom of the constitutional law in India today. Axiom, A-X-I-O-M.